Taking down monsters with a crowbar on mouse and keyboard on PlayStation Now definitely does give a different feeling to the game. However, it doesn't stop you from being distracted and getting your head chewed off. Hey everyone, and welcome to the Cloud Gaming Extreme channel. Today we're having a look at mouse and keyboard usage on PlayStation Now with no PlayStation 4 controller plugged in at all. In fact, no controllers plugged in at all. As you can see up in the top right, I'm using my mouse and keyboard, which is mapped to a PlayStation 4 controller using some software called ReWASD. As you can see, moving around, it's extremely fluid. You will need to play with your sensitivity of the Y and X axes in game to get a good balance of your mouse versus your joystick sensitivity, but other than that, it does play exceptionally well. Most of the time it's okay, but if you do run out of ammo and sometimes you forget what your melee button is or your dodge button, which can make it a bit frustrating, but as long as you remember your mappings, it is a flawless experience. So let's dive into how to set this up. First off, you'll need to download some software called ReWASD. I'll put the link in the description below. As you can see from my controller here, that I do not have a controller plugged in. So I'm going to open the ReWASD software, and there is a free trial for this, so I do urge you to test it out. And because I'm not sure what devices are which of what I've got plugged in, I can use the detection mode, which is this little like radar icon, and if I click that, any button inputs I do will flash up which device it is on the left hand side. So I can see my mouse is the G502 Hero mouse and my keyboard is the Corsair mechanical gaming keyboard. Once I've got those two, you can just verify that it's picked up the right types, the fact that it's a keyboard and a mouse, and then I need to group them together. To do this, I hit the little plus icon next to the keyboard that I've got selected here, go into the plus here and select the Hero Gaming Mouse and hit save. This now groups them together, which is vital for this controller mapping. So the other devices I don't really need to care about there, and you can see that I've got no mapping applied. So if I go up to the three bars in the top right, it actually comes pre-programmed with a PS4 remote play mapping. So if I select that, I can have a look at the mappings of what's on the mouse here and see that the mouse movement is bound to the right stick. And I can look through the keyboard controls to see what they're mapped to. Now you might notice something's missing considering this is supposed to be a PlayStation 4 mapping. These are not all PlayStation 4 buttons, there's quite a few missing. If you look at the top row, there is an icon that looks like an Xbox icon. That's because these are the Xbox control mappings. So what you need to do is hit that Xbox button, which will take you to the virtual controller settings, and change the virtual control pad to a virtual DS4. If you don't do this, then you won't get the commands for the touchpad, and you won't have some of the mappings that you would expect for the button configuration. So now you can see that as I switch that to PS4, I've got the controller mapping, so delete and the B button are my touchpad clicks, which will come in vital when you want to look at your inventory, and we'll come on to swipe stuff later when we look at Killzone. So once you've got those set up, we need to make sure that that's applied. I didn't hit save after changing it to the PlayStation 4 DS controller, which will catch me out a little bit later on. But if you want to use the associated apps, you can see that that's already set up for the PlayStation 4 launcher. And if I hit that target icon next to apply instead of applying it all the time, then only when I switch to the PlayStation 4 streamer does that mapping kick in. And you can see that it's picked up that I've got a controller now, which is that virtual DS4 controller, and will start the game for me. So as I said, you do need to make sure that you saved it when you had that PlayStation 4 controllers change, otherwise you will end up still with an Xbox controller and being as confused as I was. So let's dive into some Killzone Shadowfall gameplay, as this had a mapping that I wasn't expecting. So using Q is actually L1 here. It asked me to do a zipline, and to do this I needed to use the swipe pad right to change the mapping. So I had a look through the mappings and saw that there wasn't actually one on here for the swipe pad movements. We had the swipe pad click, but no left, right, up and down motions. So because I didn't know what other buttons to do this to, WS, A and D kind of seemed logical to me with a button configuration. So you can look here, I can actually use something called the shift commands. So on the shift 1, which is actually active if I hold down the control key by default, none of these are mapped. So I'm actually going to map all of the swipe pad movements to the up, down, left, right to WS, A and D under the shift 1 configuration. So this now means when I'm playing, if I hold the control key, my WS, A and D will then be the swipe pad movements. And more importantly, obviously making sure that that PlayStation virtual controller type is selected and saving the configuration when you exit. So as I click out, you hear that click, it's not actually applied. If I switch back to the window by hitting the Windows key to come out of my configuration, I can now save those settings. And now when that controller mapping is applied, if I hit Control and D, it will now give me my zip line. So that's how to map the swipe pad controls to your virtual controller. And once you've done it once, you won't have to do that again, and you'll be able to just remember those controls when you're playing the game. So as you can see here, for some Shadowfall gameplay, I've actually also tweaked the sensitivity of my X and Y axes so that it's much closer to my mouse sensitivity, and you can see just how much more responsive this is. The 1, 2, 3, 4 buttons also map to the left, right, up and down D-pad controls. It also takes a bit of getting used to which one is which, but actually having the adrenaline and the charged sniper shot gave a really nice effect there. I'll leave you with a bit more of the Shadowfall gameplay here as I take on some enemies using the mouse and keyboard configuration. Let us know in the comments below if you're going to dive into the PS4 remote play now that you have a virtual DS4 controller at your disposal. There is a cost of up to $20 for all of the package, but you can use the software for free for up to 14 days to make sure it's the right solution for you. Thanks for watching, don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things cloud gaming, and we will see you next time.